Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I want to explain why your blood sugar might be so high in the morning. After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, also recipes for different goals, such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. Morning blood sugar readings can sometimes be all over the place, depending on what you had for dinner or what snacks you had during the evening. What time you took your medicine can play a factor as well. But if you have consistently high blood glucose readings every morning, it could be one of three reasons that we're going to discuss in this video. The first is called the dawn phenomenon. Researchers feel this is probably the most common reason for high blood glucose levels in the morning. The glucose is going up from sources other than digested food. Some of it is produced by the liver from stored starch and fatty acids. Livers that produce too much glucose are one of the main ways diabetes causes high blood glucose levels, period. Other organs also produce small amounts of glucose. Now, this is called gluconeogenesis. That's for those of you who like the technical stuff. Now, organs produce glucose to keep blood glucose from going too low at night or other times of not eating. And from about 2 to 8 a.m., most people's bodies produce hormones including cortisol, glucagon, and epinephrine. All of these hormones increase insulin resistance and tell the liver to make more glucose. The idea is to get you enough glucose to get you out of bed and start the day. Now, everyone has a type of dawn phenomenon. Otherwise, they'd be too weak to get breakfast. Insulin levels also increase to handle the extra glucose. People with diabetes can't increase insulin levels that much, so their early morning glucose readings are dramatically high. Experts are all over the place on how many people have dawn phenomenon. I saw estimates range from 3% to 50% in type 2s and 25 to 50 in type 1s. Well, is the dawn phenomenon a serious problem? It can be. According to the American Diabetes Association, some people with dawn phenomenon find their glucose continues to rise until they can eat breakfast. For others, levels will settle down a few hours after waking, regardless of whether they eat or not. Now, according to columnist Will Dubois, the higher your A1C, the more likely you are to have significant dawn phenomenon. It could be that spending a number of hours each morning out of control is having a significant effect on your overall control. Now, some people have high glucose levels in the morning because their medicines wear off overnight. This could be true of medicines like insulin and metformin. If you're taking any long-acting medicine, consider asking your doctor about changing meds, doses, or times, and we'll talk about that a little bit later in the video. In some cases, medicines can be too strong. If your glucose goes too low in the night, you could have a rebound high in the morning. This is called the Somogyi effect. If you are waking up with high blood glucose and are suffering pounding headaches or find your sheets sweat-soaked, the odds are you're having lows in your sleep, and you need to visit your doctor and talk about taking less meds. According to Dubois, the new insulins are much less likely to cause the Somogyi effect, but because of cost, people are going back to the NPH insulin. NPH is a cheaper, shorter-acting insulin and more likely to cause a low at night, leading to a rebound high in the morning. The third reason, and we've kind of discussed this a little bit in both of the other two, but a waning insulin. If you take insulin and have been experiencing high blood sugar in the morning, well, your insulin may simply be wearing off too soon. If this is the case, your doctor can adjust your dosage, change what time you're taking the insulin to prevent high glucose levels. Now, it's very important to understand why and what's causing these morning hyperglycemia episodes before your doctor can treat you. To pinpoint which of the three reasons is behind your high numbers, you need to check and record your blood glucose levels before you go to bed at 3 a.m. and then the first thing in the morning. Now, I know it isn't fun setting an alarm in the middle of the night to stick your finger and draw blood and check your glucose, but you're going to have to do this for a few nights in a row. If your blood sugar is fairly even when you go to bed and at 3 a.m., but it's higher in the morning, more than likely you're experiencing dawn phenomenon. If your blood sugar is low at 3 a.m., but high in the morning, you are probably suffering from the Somogyi effect. If your blood sugar is high at 3 and then still higher in the morning, well, then you probably have waning insulin. Now, even if you've identified the reason behind your high morning number, never attempt to correct it on your own. Instead, talk with your doctor. Together, you can find a treatment plan that gets you back on track. Well, how will this be done? Well, once you and your doctor determine how your blood sugar levels are behaving at night, then he or she can advise you about the changes you need to make to better control them. Changes may include changing the time you take the long-acting insulin in the evening so that its peak action occurs when your blood sugars rise in the morning. Changing the type of insulin you take in the evening. Maybe taking extra insulin overnight. Eating a lighter breakfast. Increasing your morning dose insulin is another way, or you may be switched to an insulin pump, which can be programmed to release additional insulin in the morning. Well, I hope this has answered your question concerning high morning blood glucose levels. Don't forget to get my new ebook, like this video, and subscribe to our channel so we can continue to bring you more informative videos like this one in the future. And if you have any questions about this video, leave those comments in the comment box and we'll get right back to you. Thanks for watching so much. My name is Ty Mason.